International Diabetes Federation to help empower individuals with diabetes to live life to the fullest. Learn more about the International Diabetes Federation and others who are taking on this disease at Medtronic.com.
I'm Aaron Schechter. This is The World. President Obama is back in Washington today, which re-election means there's no change at the very top of the U.S. government, of course. Voters didn't change much in Congress either. Different story in China, where a massive leadership change officially got underway today. The Chinese Communist Party opened a pivotal Congress, which will usher in a new set of Chinese leaders. The world's Mary Kay is in Beijing. Mary Kay, there are obviously differences between the U.S. elections this week and the Chinese process, to say the least. Tell us about today's event.
One of the big differences between China and the United States in terms of the leadership transition is, you know, in the U.S. it's very clear what the candidates' positions are, or at least what they say they are. There are a lot of debates, there's a lot of information out in the public sphere, the public can comment, the public can criticize, and nothing happens to those who criticize or comment. In China, we don't even know entirely for sure who is making the decisions about who the next leaders will be. We do know with a fair bit of likelihood that the top two leaders will be Xi Jinping and Li Keqiang.